The January unemployment and underemployment figures in the Philippines rise due to a decline in seasonal jobs. An employers group warns the situation could be aggravated further when new graduates join the labor market. Johnson Manabat reports.
The Philippines' unemployment rate climbed to 4.5% in January 2024. This translates to 2.15 million Filipinos without jobs, which is a bit higher compared to October 2023's 4.2% or equivalent to 2.09 million jobless in the country. But National Statistician and Civil Registrar General Undersecretary Claire Dennis Mapa says the latest data is lower when compared to the January 2023 unemployment rate of 4.8% or 2.3 million unemployed individuals.
Hindi naman natin masasabi na sumipa talaga ito kasi may mga trabaho nga tayo nagkaroon tayo ng mga increases in job opportunities doon sa salary and wages. Mataas na talaga yung binagsak ng mga employed persons doon sa industries like retail sale.
Aside from the retail industry, the number of unemployed also increased in the agriculture and forestry sector, public administration, manufacturing and accommodation, and food services. MAPA explains that this is a normal trend because those seasonal jobs created every last quarter of the year usually end in January. Underemployment also continued to rise, coming in at nearly 14% in January. Soccsajan has the highest underemployment rate at 26.8%, while the National Capital Region recorded the lowest rate with 8.1%. Data from the Philippine Statistics Authority show the labor force contracted during the survey period, with the overall labor force participation rate for January 2024 declining to 61.1% from 64.5% in January 2023. The top reasons cited for not joining the labor force are household duties, age-related restrictions such as being too young or old, and schooling. The return to on-site work has limited women's participation, while on-site schooling discouraged student workers. But the Employers Confederation of the Philippines says the government must prepare for additional job seekers in the coming months, especially when new graduates enter the labor market.
Ang problema is graduation na naman, no? Soon. And every year, mga fresh graduates that enter the labor market plus those who come on age, to working age, about 800,000 to 1 million. Hopefully, just bumababa na rin yung inflation rate, baka naman magtutuloy-tuloy na ng hiring at expansion.
The National Economic and Development Authority, for its part, says the government is committed to creating a favorable business environment to attract more job opportunities. Johnson Manabat, ABS-CBN News.